Hello everybody, welcome to another episode of Art Whisperer 88. This is black tissue paper, one of my favorite collage elements. Now, I notice on YouTube, many artists call this as fodder, F-O-D-D-E-R. I don't like using that term because fodder is, it's like something you can throw away. And I really value these materials. So I'd rather call them collage material. That's just me. Now I have my reused nasal spray bottle and I filled it with white house paint. And I diluted it with some water. And I'm going to make some marks here. And I think the fact that it's diluted makes it easy to spread. This way I can create very expressive textures. Now try doing small ones. Now I have to use a drop cloth because if I use cardboard or any other kind of underliner, it will stick. It's also great for making drips. Maybe I use too much water, but I do like the result. Very interesting pattern. It's not something you could buy in a store. I take pride in the fact that I can make my own patterns and textures with some household items. Let me air dry this as soon as I find somewhere to dry this on. Now with tissue, I find that it's better to use a double layer because it has a single layer. It's very, very fragile. I guess I could also do this on canvas, which would be a stronger background. I guess you could also do this with a ketchup bottle because it has a fine nozzle. Okay, I'm going to let this dry and I will be right back. Okay, I'm back. I'm going to take inspiration from a little known French artist from the mid 20th century called Maurice Estève, an abstract painter, and he did this very striking piece called Jazz 1954, and I'm going to use it as an inspiration for color combinations. And I do love his use of geometric shapes, and they're not very hard-edged geometric shapes. They're more a little softer, more organic, and that is very attractive to me. So I'm going to start by using this Blick yellow oxide, and I'm just going to do some sections here. I'm following a grid pattern, which is kind of a formal composition. Okay, that's it for the yellow oxide, and then I'm going to combine it with some cadmium red. Now I'm hoping that this doesn't dry on me, because this is a medium bodied paint. It's not watery like the fluid paint. Again, I am using Somerset, which is my all-time favorite paper. By the way, I put a few drops of dish detergent in my tub of water for my brayers, just to make cleaning a little easier. So as I'm working, it's soaking in soapy water. Okay, let's see what we have here. I think it's a good transfer because there's hardly any paint left on the plate. Very cool. So this makes a great background for what I plan to do. So I will air dry and then continue on to the next step. I'm going to do another . This time I will add a little black for some definition. Just a few drops of black make a huge difference. Thank you. very cool. I like the color combinations here. It's very painterly. Check that out. This time I'm using fluid acrylic. Now, since I'm trying to capture the layer underneath to make a ghost print, I will leave this for 5 minutes. Okay, let's see what we have here. I think we have a good transfer. I do like the consistency of the fluid acrylic. It creates these beautiful ghost prints. Check this out. Okay, as usual, I will air dry this with the help of my desk fan and then continue on to the next step. So don't go away. Okay, now for my next step, I am going to apply some of this fluid turquoise. This is light blue permanent. And since it's very watery, I'm hoping it will create some kind of texture. Combining that with just a touch of black. So in a way, this is like a split fountain where I have a band of different color in the middle. Now this time, for the sake of texture, I'm not going to make this even. I'm deliberately going to leave some parts untouched. Just making sure my hands are clean. So this is the piece that I want to introduce some texture to. Okay, let's see what we have here. I like that. Pretty cool. It's exactly what I wanted. Air dry this and continue on. To see if what's left will transfer onto this piece. It did. It added to the texture. Not a whole lot, but it does add some accent colors. Okay, so on to the third piece. Now, since this is very complex, I'm not going to add any more paint to it. I'm just going to add some collage instead. Again, I will be using my Mod Podge. Now, I don't have my bib handy, so I'm going to take a chance. I'll just be extra careful. Sit for the third print. Oh, this is a double layer. I'll see if I can separate them. I may end up destroying it, but I'm gonna try. So I think if I separate them, it will be more transparent. Yeah. So this way it will, when the glue dries, it's going to show the paint underneath. At least that's what I'm hoping. Okay. Here's the last piece. Now to work on the first one. Now these are quite large areas, so I have to be careful. I'm just lay them very gently. There's always a chance it will tear. So I will air dry all three of these and then move on to the next. Possibly recap. If I decide that it doesn't need anything anymore, I will recap and end the video. Okay, everybody, here's my favorite part of this adventure. Here is the first print, and let me show you a close-up. So I like the fact that the tissue paper almost completely disappears. There's few traces of the white paper on it, but I like the modulation. And that's why I like using one layer of tissue. Now, had it been two layers, it would be a little more opaque. So here's the first piece, and what I'll do, put this to one side so you can see it next to the inspiration piece. I have taken a few cues from the color combination, but I reinterpreted the piece. So instead of it being jazz 1954, it is jazz 2023. So here's the next piece. This has a very autumn kind of feel to it because of the colors. The second piece, and here we are at the last piece. Usually the ghost print is my favorite. It has the most complex mix of colors. Closer look. The there's a little bit of oil resist here because the fluid acrylic interacts with the oil content of the gel plate. And the collage adds some texture, like three-dimensional effect. Sometimes it shows up, sometimes not, so I can't really tell. So it's always a surprise. I hope you like this video. I had a lot of fun doing this. And thank you again for all you wonderful supporters. And to those viewers who have enough confidence in my artwork to actually buy it, please check out my new website, artwhisperer88.com. They are very reasonably priced compared to other artwork out in the market today. And all the proceeds go to help keep this channel going. Thank you again, and I hope to see you next time.